shoot the lights out, high till it's bright out. Oh, just another lonely night. Are you willing to sacrifice your life?
God the Father's prophet, holy apostle, Tazadaqyah. Spread gospel, break down the doctrine. Precepts and verses taught in all the churches. Who the one to comfort you? The holy comforter.
Gossip, gossip, nigga, just stop it. Everybody know the holy comforter, the prophet. I'ma need to see your hands at the concert.
Talking about us. A lot of people's deceived, think that's talking about the so-called truth. That's talking about us. Being in the land of Israel. So I always was like, okay, there's a big gap here. How do we get America to the land of Israel, and why? This place is going to be, and you already see this being expressed. This place is going to become so unbearable that you're going to have a lot of people that is not going to want to be here. Now, when I say that you can already see this happening, the minute Trump got elected, what people start talking about doing? This place is going to get so bad. Because you think you got rights. You was deceived that somebody can't just come get you and throw you against the wall and go in your pocket and do what they want to do, just bust in your house and do what they want to do. You believe that you protected by rights. You deceived into thinking that they cannot do certain things. But when they actually start coming and doing it, and there's no place that you can go to complain, to get any kind of recourse, this is going to be a place that you are feeling is not safe enough for you and your children, and you're going to be looking to get the hell out of here. And even though it's going to be like this all over the planet Earth, now everything makes sense, because the Lord stated when we do get into Israel, when that church is set up in Israel, it's going to grow immensely, and that the Lord is going to protect it. Now, the plan is for this. Now, let me just tell you, I'm just giving y'all the whole thing from the beginning to the end. The plan is to implement the mark of the beast, take over the whole planet Earth, deceive everybody, and for them to be in power forever. That's the plan. The monkey wrench in the plan is the truth. Stop. Stop. Okay, if you don't believe this, then why was J. Edgar Hoover looking for a black messiah? That's what COINTELPRO was all about, to find a leader that was charismatic enough, that was able to unite people, black people, and turn them against the government. He was very afraid of that. This is what he spoke about to all of the leadership. He said, we can't allow this to happen. So they destroyed everybody that looked like they was able to do something. Martin Luther King got like, I have a dream that, bah! Malcolm X, by any means, bow. Marcus Garvey, Fred Hampton, and the Black Panther Party that was walking around with guns and say, we're going to fight you back. The ones that, after they started killing, they started going to other ones and saying, you better make a deal with us or we're going to kill you, like Farrakhan. That's why he's still alive and old. And you don't see the Muslims used to march up and down the street. They used to have their bow tie. They used to show their numbers and all. They done dwinkled. They done dwindled. I said dwinkled. They done dwindled. Down to nothing. Their masses is damn out of shape, okay? Mas number 7, mas number 8, them joints is falling apart. Because he cut a deal. Now, here's the problem. And this is how the scriptures read. The Bible clearly tells you that they got the whole earth. You know who they didn't get? They didn't get the Israelite Church of God in Jesus Christ. This is why so close to 20 to 30, where they're getting ready to implement that plan, where it ain't going to be nothing but hell all over this earth, and America's going to realize what every other nation on this planet been realizing. Remember the prophecy of the missile that's coming, okay? Okay, this is something that's common in every nation on earth. Libya, Syria, then Iraq, you're all over the world. All different parts of Africa, China, all over the world. Except in America, they ain't used to this stuff, okay? So in 2016, going into 2017, attack the Israelite Church of God in Jesus Christ. Now's the time. Now's the time, because we get ready to implement everything else. We got to get rid of them. The end of the light and the beginning of darkness, November 1st. Everything is right on schedule. It's right on schedule. Now, what the scripture says is that no man can buy or sell save he that have the mark. The scriptures talk about people not eating, but then the Bible says, my servant shall eat. You use the precept with that to say what? That in the land of Israel, the scripture says that the heathen shall envy thee and shall not be able to do anything against thee. What also did it say? Thou shalt have abundance. So while they take it from everybody else, Israel is building someplace and they got a lot. While they sitting there oppressing somebody else, they're looking at Israel and saying, I'm envious of them. The scriptures also say when you read the book of Ezekiel 38, that an evil thought going to come into their mind and they say, I'm going to go up into the ones that dwell safely. While everybody else is catching hell, Israel is in the land of Israel safe. And they got upset about that. The reason why God didn't reveal the details of how we actually going to go, because they watching too. They want to know, wait, how the hell these niggas going to get in Israel? So they could try to stop it. Because they know once we there, I was there, I can tell you, Sean was there, I can tell you, if anybody ever went there, if the spirit was on you while you was there, we are so connected with that land that the minute your feet touch that land, you can feel the power, you can feel it's the home of God, you can feel it. And it's just protection there. That's where that's our promised land. Do everybody understand that? It's just protection there. So we're going to be there. We're still going to be in America. It's going to be a lot. Israelite Church of God and Jesus Christ is not going to leave America. Okay, this is not Jim Jones where I'm telling everybody, pack your bags and bring your Kool-Aid and come to Israel. Okay. How we get there is it's going to miraculously go down. Okay. But we're still going to be here. We're going to be big here. Do everybody understand that? In the persecution. Okay, but we're going to be there as well. And there, none of the mark of the beast is going to be able to take effect on us. And this is what's going to cause us to come, them to come against us. And at that time, the Lord said that the smoke is going to come up in his nostrils. And then that's when this whole thing is getting ready to be over. So now, now when you look at things according to prophecy, how close we are. We're in that next 10-year period. We're approaching that next 10-year period of 2020. To 2030, and the only thing left to be implemented, the only thing that's left to be implemented fully, is the mark of the beast. In order for that to be implemented the way it has to be implemented, that means all hell has to start breaking loose on this planet, and it's already begun. All hell has to start breaking loose in America, and it's already begun. You're going to realize that there is no rights, that this is worse than slavery, that you could be taken and held without getting a lawyer, you'll be held for years. The same thing you see them doing to the Arabs in Guantanamo Bay. All that stuff that you actually see that's becoming normal is going to start happening to Black, Hispanics, and Indians all over America. And this is the time period that we are finding ourselves in. That's why the Lord told Israel, listen, this is not your rest. Let me show you the end result of what Psalms 83 is talking about. Let's go to the book of Psalms chapter 2. The Lord ain't want to get into the details. In Psalms 82, he just told you the outcome. Yeah, they're going to consult together with one accord. They're going to be confederate against my people. But this is going to be the end results of that. Do everybody understand that? Let's go to the book of Psalms chapter 2. And we're going to start at the first verse. Psalms chapter 2 verse 1. Read that.
Why do the heathen rage?
Same thing, that tumult, that noise of them getting in control of Israel. Read on.
And the people imagine a vain thing.
Okay, the vain thing is that they're going to be successful in their plans against the nation of Israel. Read on.
The kings of the earth set themselves, and the rulers take counsel together.
Okay, it's the same thing in Psalms 83. Everybody see that? Read on.
Against the Lord.
Against what?
The Lord.
Read on.
And against...
Shoot the lights out, high till it's bright out. Oh, just another lonely night. Are you willing to sacrifice your life?
God the Father's prophet, holy apostle, Tazadaqyah. Spread gospel, break down the doctrine, precepts and verses, taught in all the churches. Who the one to comfort you? The holy comfort.